are here and we are in Spitalfields Market and we're about to go in to see one of London's upcoming and most talented designers, Joshua Kane. That's enough from me, let's go inside. Please tell us a bit about your collection.
Okay, I'll sort of focus on some key elements of it.
Please do.
Because I think that's the best way to sort of break down the depth of the collection. This is a small part of the collection. Judging by the looks, this is just literally like the first 4 to 5 looks. So it's a really, really small capsule of it. The collection was titled The Grand Illusion. So it was focused on very famous illusionists at the turn of the century. There was sort of a little bit of play with picking out the illusions that the illusionists were famous for and then focusing on that and then using that as sort of a literal interpretation to the design.
That's so interesting. I like that.
Yeah, and then as the collection evolved, it became sort of fused with some modernity. It's actually about the performer. The magician was actually the rock star of the time. They were the person on stage that everyone sort of aspired to be. And then in this day and age, that really just comes down to the lead singer of the band. You know, that really obvious transition between that person that everyone looks at, stares at, wants to dress like, wants to be inspired by. So by taking this sort of illusionist concept and then taking it to this modern day sort of rock star, as it were, we call it the rock and roll collection. As I sort of mentioned before, I design all of my own fabrics. They're all woven in the UK for me as well. So we're 100% English designed, English manufactured, English produced, so all the way through.
Yay!
Which is a nice thing to be able to say.
Yeah.
And of course, with the title being The Grand Illusion, all of the fabrications, it was about taking traditional English patination and then playing with the scale, really taking the polka dot and blowing it up to this huge interpretation
really nice,
of the polka dot. It's also a double-faced cloth, so the reverse side of a cloth is actually like so.
Beautiful.
And again, as I mentioned before about this idea of playing with twins and opposites, so we actually had the twins wearing the two suits, the reverse colours of each other. So it had a real play from the design to also the theatre we then produced with it. Again, going into checks of these really bold interpretations of traditional checks and then made really summery with mohair blends. And then we have our seasonal design, which was our illusion, we called it. So it's the illusion clock inspired by, I believe, Houdin. So he produced this clock that it was built with mirrors, so basically you couldn't see all the internal cogs, etc. And then we designed this artwork, which is this oversized cathedral, which actually you can see the artwork over there on the wall. It's still not been taken down. And then you've got Tesla within it as well, within this cathedral setting.
I need to just take this. I'm sorry. Sorry, guys. I'm all. No, we'll just keep lighting.
Yeah, this is brilliant. This is really good.
And then when we engineered the lay plan, so it all matches and wraps 360 degrees all the way around the body.
Wow.
And then comes back again. So it creates this whole scene, this whole sort of almost pictorial diagram of this mood that we're trying to create. But this was a really signature design.
It's brilliant.
But then
really incredible.
Carried through into our luggage collection as well, as you can see. So then this really became sort of a signature. This also
really
appeared
beautiful.
In ties and scarves,
yeah.
And then also in waistcoats. I mentioned Tesla, of course, very famous with his manipulations of lightning and electricity.
The most significant, I would say.
Yeah.
And I think what's beautiful about him as well is just the way that he had this vision of creating something that would help people.
Of course.
So this is beautiful.
So then we have our actual gold threadwork lightning inspired collar on the traditional wool imperial raincoat. Detachable, but something that we took, again, taking this artwork and really sort of formulating it within a literal interpretation, but also making it fun as well. It's going to disappear into the rabbit hole. Other interpretations of then how it developed. We have our red military studded sort of rock and roll jacket.
It's got the polka dot colour.
Of course, so that's a, that's my signature polka dot with a top hat. Again, all the linings, as I mentioned, are ours.
Yeah, I need this jacket as well.
It's heavy.
I need this jacket. It needs to be mine. I'm taking it home.
No, I'll give you back, but I need it after.
Please.
Okay, don't tell anyone after. I'm taking this home.
Signature houndstooth, which is the one that, of course, I mentioned Oliver wore back at the beginning.
Yes.
So a really key fabrication actually for us, and we're just sort of starting it to deliver now. So it's the beginning, the first sort of pre-fall collection coming in, which is sort of really exciting for us, I think, to go from producing two prior collections and then doing a runway collection and then getting all the press and the attention that we managed to generate from that collection and then our beginning to produce it in store. It's sort of a really exciting big step for us. It's sort of a really satisfying sort of nod to all the hard work that the team's put in.
Brilliant.
I think this being particularly poignant, our jacquarded three tailor scarf, which you can see is featured as part of the main wall hanging there. Again, this was a really key accessory for the season. Sort of 2 meters wide with the tassels beautifully woven in England, creating this wonderful blanket scarf. And that was, that was something that was really made a statement and an impact within the collection, and something people have been talking about quite a lot.
Brilliant. Oh, I love the scarves and the hats. You've just got the full collection here. Absolutely incredible work.
Thank you very much.
I'm so proud, and I'm so excited to see what comes up in 2016, 2017.
Thank you. It's going to be an exciting
year. Thank you, guys. Yes. Joshua Keane.
Thank you very much.